He did, however, make one point. The witness swore positively that Charles's manner had betrayed no unusual excitement on the night on which he dined, the night on which he was accused of changing the pills. Rollins was called next. With evident regret, he told about Charles taking the pictures to be cleaned and bringing them back, in each case giving the dates. On the call of Samuel Truelove, Charles saw that the whole of the picture episode was coming out. How the police had found Truelove he could not imagine, or indeed how they had got on to the question of the pictures at all. The oily gentleman, whom he had met in Arundel Street, seemed more at home in the box than had the previous witnesses. He described very fairly, as Charles had to admit, their interview. Charles had brought the pictures, saying he wished to raise a loan on them for about 6 months. He, witness, had had them valued, and he'd been able to offer £2,100 on them. Charles had agreed to this figure, and the money had been paid over in notes in order, he had said, to avoid the transaction passing through his bank and becoming known. Being cross-examined with the easygoing slackness which made Charles so furious, the accused had mentioned a period of 6 months at the probable time during which he would require the loan. Was this strictly so? Had no other period been mentioned? In reply, Truelove said that at first Charles had not known how long he might want to be accommodated, then had mentioned 6 months as a basis of discussion. He had, however, ascertained that the firm would keep the pictures for possible redemption for a period of 2 years. He had remarked that this would suit him, as before the end of 2 years his business would be either flourishing or dead. With regard to Charles's precautions to secure secrecy, Truelove admitted that this was a usual accompaniment of business done with his firm.